गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू द नेक्स्ट सेशन ऑफ वन वर्ड सब्स्टिट्यूशन। माई सेल्फ दिनेश मिगलानी, यू हैव वॉच्ड माई अर्लियर वीडियोज ऑन डिफरेंट एरियाज ऑफ वोकैबुलरी, मैथमेटिक्स, रीजनिंग, जनरल नॉलेज। यू मे कनेक्ट मी ऑन माई फेसबुक @दिनेश मिगलानी और माई व्हाट्सएप नंबर इज 0921551435। लेट अस स्टार्ट विद दिस सेशन, वन वर्ड सब्स्टिट्यूशन। My first word is one who is indifferent to the both pleasures and pain, stoic. It's a specific word here that is used for a person who is indifferent towards pleasure and pain. Means he is not affected if some pleasure moment is there, or if there is some pain moment, he is also not affected with that. That is stoic, right? A few other words are there: saint, ascetic, and hermit. When we talk about saint, sadhu, hermit can be also taken for the same word, and ascetic means who has left the world, who has left all the things of the world. So that is said to be ascetic, vairagi, right? Here my answer is said to be stoic. One who is against the standard of ordinary society, especially in dressing, right? Sometime when you watch in the movies, the American style persons in the 1960s and 70s, where they were against the standard of ordinary society in the terms of the dressing, they are said to be hippies. What we call them? Hippie, right? Here my answer is said to be hippie. Few other words are given: joker, it's a clown sort of, scapegoat, special word is bali ka bakra. Means when we talk about this, scapegoat is one who is blamed for the wrongs of other, right? That is said to be scapegoat, right? Here answer is said to be hippie. Hippie are the those persons who were against the traditional society in the terms of dressing, right? They are said to be hippies. The next word is murder of a brother, right? You all know that when there is a word used for the killing or the murder, the side is behind them. When we talk about this word, patricide means killing of father, regicide, killing of a king or a queen, homicide, killing of a human being, fratricide, killing of the brother. So here my specific word here is, because I have to find out the murder of a brother, that is said to be fratricide. So let us again revise: patricide, killing of the father, second is the regicide, killing of the king, third one is homicide, killing of a human being, and fratricide is killing of brother. The next word is mania for stealing articles, kleptomania. The word here is kleptomania. C is my answer. Kleptomania is a specific word used for a person who has a mania for stealing articles, right? Although he does not require them, but he steals articles only for the sake of his pleasure or mania. That is kleptomania. Few other words are there. Logomania means who has a mania for talking, who speaks too much. जो उन्मादी है बोलने के लिए, दैट इज सेड टू बी लोगोमेनिया। देन यू हैव निम्फोमेनिया, हु हैज अ मेनिया टुवर्ड्स अ वुमन, निम्फोमेनिया, राइट? द हेयर वर्ड इज सेड टू बी निम्फोमेनिया, राइट? और वी कैन से इट्स एन अनकंट्रोलेबल डिजायर फॉर द वुमन, राइट? हाइपोमेनिया, हाइपोमेनिया मीन्स ए माइल्ड फॉर्म ऑफ मेनिया, हाइपोमेनिया। Hence my answer is said to be kleptomania for this, right? So we have learned two more words here: the logomania, who has a mania for talking, nymphomania, and excessive a desire for the woman, that is said to be nymphomania, right? Mental weariness for want of occupation, thaka hua, dimagi taur se thaka hua, kyunki kaam zyada kiya, fatigue. Kya word use karte hai? Fatigue, right? Fatigue is a specific word used for here. And some other words are there, that is the debility. Debility, we can say that the physical weakness, right? That here it is said to be debility, physical weakness. Then you have ennui, it's a sort of lack of excitement. And then you have langour, that is tiredness. So there is a difference between fatigue and langour. Fatigue is mentally tiredness, right? And when we talk about the langour, that is a physical tiredness, right? Here my specific answer here is fatigue. The next is mania for travel. When we talk about the mania for travel, that is the dromomania. Here my answer is said to be dromomania. Some other words are there: bibliomania. Bibliomania means the mania for books, right? Pyromania, mania for fire, right? And logomania, earlier I told you, it's a mania for talking, right? So here my answer is said to be dromomania, mania for travel. ए पर्सन लिविंग परमानेंटली इन ए सर्टेन प्लेस, नेटिव, ए पर्सन लिविंग परमानेंटली इन ए सर्टेन प्लेस, द नेटिव आर दोज पर्सन्स दैट्स देयर ओरिजिनल प्लेस ऑफ लिविंग, राइट. Here my answer must be the domicile. Here my answer must be the domicile. Domicile means that's your permanent place to live, right? That is said to be domicile. The answer is said to be C. Now here is a need to understand the difference between the A and C. So what is the difference between the native and the domicile? When we talk about the native, native means the persons who live at their original place, means in original place from where your background is there, that we can say that is named as the natives, or we can say local people. And the domicile means those persons who live permanently at a particular place. So we can say they are the those persons have the domicile there. So answer is said to be C. Paying back injury with injury. A very important word here. Few more words are given. Reprisal, revenge. One word is there. Reprisal, that is said to be revenge. Repression, suppress someone. Right. Suppress means किसी पे दबाव डालना. That is said to be repression. Subjugation, to conquer. Subjugate, to win, right? And vendetta is a specific word here. That is paying back injury with injury, right? If someone attacked on you, you just take a revenge from that person by giving injury for the same. So that is said to be vendetta. Hence my answer is said to be A, right? It's not revenge, but it's not that D, reprisal, because that is simply revenge. It does not mean that the same injury you are going to inflict on that person, right? And here we have to give the same injury to the person, so then we can say that is vendetta. A is my answer. Next is acutely affected by external impressions. A very important word, that is acutely affected by external impressions, right? That is impressionable. Impressionable means a person who is prone for affected by the external impressions, right? Some more words are there. Ingenious. Ingenious means very clever person. That is said to be the credulous, who believes very easily, right? Or we can say over trustful. When we talk about this word credulous, a person who believes on the others very easily, they are said to be credulous. Sensitive, a very sensitive person, right? Very soft person who is easily affected by the emotions, that is said to be sensitive, right? Here answer is said to be impressionable, acutely affected by external impressions. To slap with a flat object. Some words are there, to slap with a flat object. My answer is said to be swat here. Here the specific word for this is swat. Few more words are there. Chop. Chop means chopping of the vegetables. Then you have hew. Hew means to cut with an axe. Axe with kulhadi. किसी चीज को कुल्हाड़ी से काटना, दैट इज सेड टू बी ह्यू, राइट. एंड देन यू हैव द ग्नो. ग्नो मींस च्यू समथिंग, च्यू, चबाना, राइट. हियर आंसर टू माय दिस वर्ड इज ग्नो, दैट इज टू च्यू. ह्यू इज अ वर्ड यूज फॉर व्हेन यू कट विद एन एक्स. चोप इज टू कट. स्वैट इज अ स्पेसिफिक वर्ड वेयर दैट इज यूज फॉर टू स्लैब विद ए फ्लैट ऑब्जेक्ट समवन, दैट इज सेड टू बी स्वैट. एन असेंबली ऑफ हियरर, ऑडियंस. असेंबली ऑफ हियरर इज सेड टू बी ऑडियंस, राइट. Generally, this word is used audience, where some persons are there who have been gathered to hear someone. They are said to be audience. Crowd, you know, bheed, assemblage, an assembly, or we can say collection. Congregation. Congregation means where person have been gathered for the purpose of God, or we can say for religious purpose. The word here is congregation. Congregation. Right, it means the gathering for a religious purpose. The gathering for religious purpose, that is said to be congregation. Okay, and audience is assembly of hearers. Next is an associate in an office or an institution. That is said to be colleague. Colleagues are those persons who work with you in a company, in an office. So here my answer is said to be colleague. Right. Here we have few more words are there that we can say. They are said to be ally. Ally is your helper, accomplice, help someone in bad sense, help someone in wrongful act. They are said to be accomplice, right? So here my answer is said to be an associate of a person in an office, that is said to be colleague, right?